Merhaba arkadaşlar. Hello everyone. Welcome to fourth lesson of Turkish from scratch. Today we will be learning first person plural pronoun in Turkish. That is biz. Biz is the first person plural pronoun in Turkish. Okay, let's get started. Biz 3 kişiyiz. Biz öğrenciyiz. Biz 22 yaşındayız. Biz uzun boyluyuz. Biz sarışınız. Biz kiloluyuz ama güçsüzüz. Biz yorgunuz, biz üzgünüz, biz çalışkanız, biz hep yoğunuz ve yorgunuz. Okay, let's get started. So, biz is we. We, biz üç kişiyiz. Kişi here means person. Person. Okay, so biz üç kişiyiz means here, 3 kişi means 3 people, right? People. And biz 3 kişiyiz means we are 3 people. So here are is equal to here is, right? This is actually is, and this ye is buffering ye because it connects two vowels, right? So biz 3 kişiyiz. We are 3 people. Biz öğrenciyiz. We are, öğrenci was meaning student, right? We learned it in the previous lessons. Öğrenciyiz. Again, is the suffix for this pronoun, first person plural pronoun in Turkish, and ye was buffering ye. So we understand that in Turkish with biz, the suffix is comes together. Okay, in the noun sentences with biz, the suffix is comes together. Biz öğrenciyiz. So if the subject of the sentence is biz, we need to use this suffix after the word here in the noun sentences, right? Biz öğrenciyiz. Biz 22 yaşındayız. Again, we are 22 yaşında. Yaşında was meaning years old, right? So, we are 22 years old. 22 years old. Biz 22 yaşındayız. Is again the suffix for your personal pronoun. And ye again, buffering ye, connecting two vowels here. And the next sentence is, biz uzun boyluyuz. Biz uzun boyluyuz. Biz... We uzun boylu. Uzun boylu was meaning long, right? Long. Uz again here the suffix for biz, and ye again buffering ye here. So biz uzun boyluyuz. We are long. Biz sarışınız. Again we sarışın. Sarışın was meaning blonde, right? Blonde. Biz sarışınız. Is here suffix just is because the last letter of the word is consonant, so we just needed to add is. Is is a suffix for here biz. And because of the here last vowel of the word, this is, right? After a or ı, we use is. We were using and sen. If you remember, with ben and sen, the same thing here for biz. Biz sarışınız. Biz kiloluyuz ama güçsüzüz. Biz, we, kilolu. Kilolu was meaning fat, right? Fat or overweight. Fat. Biz kiloluyuz. Again here uz for suffix biz, and ye is buffering ye. Biz kiloluyuz ama güçsüzüz. Güçsüz was meaning powerless or weak, right? Weak. And üz. Üz is the suffix for here biz, personal pronoun biz. Biz kiloluyuz Ama biz güçsüzüz. We are fat, but we are weak. Ama was meaning but, right? Biz yorgunuz. We yorgun. Yorgun means tired, right? Tired. Biz yorgunuz. Us again, the suffix for here, personal pronoun, biz. First person, plural pronoun in Turkish, biz, we are tired. We are tired, biz yorgunuz. Biz üzgünüz. Üzgün means sad. Biz üzgünüz, we are sad. Us again, suffix for biz. Biz çalışkanız. Çalışkan means hardworking or diligent. Biz çalışkanız. Is again the suffix for biz. Biz hep yoğunuz ve yorgunuz. Biz, we, hep. Hep was meaning always. Yoğun. Yoğun means busy. Busy. Biz hep yoğunuz. We are always busy. And ve and yorgunuz. Yorgun was meaning here tired. Okay. Yorgunuz, tired. So here us and us again the suffix for biz. Personal pronoun, first person, plural pronoun in Turkish, biz. Biz hep yoğunuz ve yorgunuz. We are always busy and tired. Okay, so we learned that with biz, if the subject of the sentence is biz, we need to use this suffix. Is, is, us, us after the word. So biz comes with this suffix. Is, is, us, us. Okay, so the formula is, so the formula for biz, first person, plural pronoun in Turkish, is if the subject of the sentence is biz, we need to use the suffix is after the word. If the last vowel of the word is a or ı, we add is as suffix. For example, biz çalışkanız. Çalışkan is the word here, was meaning hardworking, and the suffix is is, right? So, biz çalışkanız. As the word, here we see çalışkan, the last vowel of the word here is a, we use is as suffix. If the last vowel of the word is e or i, we use is as suffix. For example, biz öğrenciyiz. Öğrenci was meaning student, right? So we added is. E is the last vowel of this word. And we added is as suffix. And here we needed to use buffering ye also because the last letter of the word is vowel. So we can say that here like is. Okay, is, blah blah, is. If the last letter of the word is consonant, we add is. And if the last letter of the word is vowel, we add is. Okay. If the last vowel of the word is o or u, we add us as suffix. For example, biz yorgunuz. Yorgun was meaning tired, right? So the last vowel of the word yorgun is u. So we added us as suffix. And lastly, if the last vowel of the word is ö or ü, we add üz as suffix. Biz üzgünüz. Üzgün means sad, right? So, the last vowel of the word is ü. We added üz as suffix here. So we learned that if the subject of the sentence is this, we need to use is as suffix. Okay friends, that's it for today. I hope you understood it very well. Don't forget to practice and don't forget to study the written material in our website turkishtome.com. You can download the PDF file also there. Don't forget to visit and check it out. And also if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.